Ladies and gents, everything between and without, and welcome back to another thing I will never LP. On today's list, we have a little platformer from 2013 called 140 on 140. Now, as you can see and can hear, this is a platformer based on a very simple idea. It's minimalistic, and it deals with, its main thing is synesthesia, which is basically translation of sound into images. You can't hear this, but during the game, a song is playing, and basically, this song influences the level. How? For example, that ball. So that ball moved on that road, on that pattern, after a according to a certain subset of the song. So for example, you go. So here, for example, you saw that platform to the right, but now I was going the wrong way. But whatever. And that was dead. So you hear the song and you detect some patterns, and you associate that pattern with a movement in the scene. So for example, here you hear a note. You hear a part of a song start to play, and then you know that road begins to be constructed. So, for example, you know, you see, and then after a while, when you see the pattern, then you know exactly how it will go. So, for example, you know, here you have to wait for the pattern to end, go up there, and then jump from there to the next platform. This is a very enjoyable platformer. It's minimalistic but simple. It keeps you on edge, and it's fun. Yeah. What else can I say? The reason I won't be LPing this is very simple. Because it's based on synesthesia, a large part of the game is listening to the music in order to synchronize yourself. And what can I say? You know, YouTube, music, copyright. You can guess why I'm not inclined to actually let's play this. However, that doesn't mean that it's not a good game. On the contrary, I enjoy it. It's simple, it's fun, and if you enjoy simple, fun, quick indie games, then I suggest you try it out. Is that all? I think that's all. This has been a very short episode of this playlist, but I hope it has been informative. Because this game, even though it's simple, it can keep you occupied for you know, an hour, 2 hours, and it has some very interesting mechanics, as you can clearly see, of course. So for example, here you listen to the song and you determine when you can jump for the circle. And basically, a level ends once you get this orb, and you go with it to the eye. Once you get to the eye, then you go forward to the next level, kind of. Well, this has been another installment of Things I Will Never LP. I hope you've enjoyed it. Again, this has been the game called 140, and if you like what you see and dig the idea of a game based on synesthesia, then you know, buy it. It's cheap, it's fun, it's short, it's, you know, it's good. Goodbye.